Ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum. It's a session, an eloquent truth, in conversation with Jugnu Mohsin, and the moderator is Alia Iqbal Naqvi. She's a historian by training, committed to the development of education in Pakistan, particularly the furthering of humanistic learning. Alia currently heads a liberal arts program at the Indus Valley School of Art and Architecture. Welcome, ma'am. During the session, you all are requested to put your cell phone on silent mode so that we can have an uninterrupted session. Thank you. Over to Alia.
Thank you. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure you're all as excited as I am to be entertained for an hour by the incomparable Jugnu Mohsin, who we all know mainly in her incarnation as the editor and writer of the satirical column at the back of the Friday Times. The Friday Times has been a part of my life growing up in Pakistan for the 25 years that it's been around. The columns written by Jugnu at on the back page of the Friday Times have informed my political understanding of this country, apart from being hugely entertaining. Jugnu, I wanted to start by, our session is called An Eloquent Truth, which is a reference to how humor and satire in particular, and a sense of the ridiculous, really gets under the skin of things to the truth of the matter, and that is your bread and butter. So how did it all start? When did you first write this satirical column for the back page of the Friday Times?
I think that came much later.
Sorry, not very tech savvy. That came much later. It came when I returned to Pakistan, married, and began to build my life here. But what happened very early on in my life is that I've always been a mimic, and I've always had a sense of the ridiculous, and I've always, as we were discussing just now over lunch, I always tend to pick up things as I go along when I see things in everyday life and I sense that something is ridiculous, and I look at the funny side of things, and I sort of, they just go into my brain somewhere, and then they come out somewhere or the other. And that's what it's been like all my life. That's the person that I am. So when somebody's talking to me, for instance, they need to be careful because I'm always picking up what they're saying, there's sort of certain mannerisms, etc. And I draw inspiration from everyday things. I grew up in the 1970s in the Punjab, in Lahore, in the rural areas. That was a time of such ferment, there was a time of radical ideas, that there was a time of cultural openness, etc. Of course, at the same time, my family was moaning and groaning about their land being taken over and their industries being nationalized, etc. So that was the other end of it. But there was a lot of political ferment, and I became political as a person in the 1970s, and I acquired my worldview, I think, at that time. And there was a lot of inspiration, for instance, on Pakistan television. There used to be this satirical program called Sach Gup, which was pioneered by Shoaib Hashmi and Naveed Shehzad, who has been part of this festival as well. Salima Hashmi, Salman Shahid, they were all part of that. And as a child, I used to be glued to the television when that used to happen. And I mean, remember, those were the days when corruption was something that people were still revolted by. Corruption was something that people still felt jolted by. And there was this Naveed Shehzad, her pigtails, etc., playing a little girl who was a civil servant's daughter. And that was also the good old days when you could smuggle drugs and gold and currency out of the country on any airliner, when there weren't machines to go through, etc., etc. And people used to do things like that. And she used to appear on television in Sach Gup, and she used to say, and apologies to people who don't understand Urdu here, because I have to lapse into that and Punjabi and all of that during this time. And she'd sit there with her pigtails and black and white television, and I as a little girl used to be glued to it. And she used to say, Meri abbu kehti hain ki beti tumhari jo guri hai na uske andar hum sona bhar ke leke jayenge kyunki wo phir ameer ho jayegi. And things like that. And she'd say, abbu mere kehte ammi ko ki khabardar mere samne tumne rishwat ka naam liya, mujhe rishwat se adawat hai.
सिर्फ सिर्फ अगर किसी ने कोई अच्छा काम करवाना है ना तो एक मिठाई का डब्बा मुझे कबूल है, और मिठाई जो है ना सिर्फ उसके अंदर मुझे जो चीज़ें अच्छी लगती हैं ना, बर्फी हो, गुलाब जामुन हो, छोटी सी डली सोने की हो, कलाकंद हो, उसके अंदर जलेबी हो, छोटी सी डली सोने की हो, उसके अंदर और जलेबी हो और एक छोटी सी डली और सोने की होनी चाहिए बस, और मुझे रिश्वत से दावत. एंड शी यूज्ड टू से थिंग्स लाइक दिस ऑन सच गप ऑन पाकिस्तान टेलीविजन, एंड ऑफ कोर्स आई यूज्ड टू लैप इट अप एंड लव इट. And then, of course, there was the great Habib Jalib, who was also there in the background doing all his poetry. And badi wo inqilabi shayari bhi karte the, aur uske saath wo tanqeedi bhi badi shayari karte the. And I remember it stuck in my head at that time as a child when he used to, when he wrote this poem called Qaid-e Awam. And it was a sort of a critique of Mr. Bhutto. Main Qaid-e Awam hoon, main Qaid-e Awam hoon, main Pisre Shahnawaz hoon, main Pidre Benazir hoon, main bilkul bezameer hoon, main Qaid-e Awam hoon. ये जो सब मेरे वजीर हैं ये बिल्कुल बेज़मीर हैं, मैं सब का पेश इमाम हूँ, मैं कायदे अवाम हूँ. तो ये चीज़ें भी सुनने को मिलती थी उस वक्त, एंड इट वाज़ ऑल पार्ट ऑफ वंस रेडिकल सॉर्ट ऑफ ग्रोइंग अप. सो आई नोटेड ऑल ऑफ दैट, एंड देन आई वेंट टू स्कूल इन इंग्लैंड टू डू माय ए लेवल्स एटसेट्रा, एंड आई वाज़ एक्सपोज टू अ बॉडी ऑफ इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट्स. वन ऑफ माई क्लोजेस्ट फ्रेंड्स एट दैट टाइम वॉज अ सऊदी गर्ल, and you know she I used to think that isko kuch aata hi nahi hai siway anarohalan. I mean, she used to always be wanting to go to London from school. We were living in the middle of the English countryside. It was a boarding school, etc. aur uske upar badi kadi nazar rakhi hui thi wahan par administration ne, because her father had given specific instructions ke she is not to be allowed out unless I say that she is going to, her name was Nahid. And she used to, and I went to London. And then finally, when she went to London, and this is in my second year at that school, and I was at that time, for my sins, sort of head prefect. And I used to do telephone duty at night, and her father used to ring up, and he used to say, "This is Badr Hussain Salim calling from Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. Can I talk to Madhu the Nahid, please?" अच्छा वो मुझे कह के गई होती थी कि listen, you want, I mean, I have to admit to a slightly sort of corruption and on my part, but she used to say, "You want your tuck box to be filled, darling. I come back with the nice gifts from a delicatessen in London." And so I used to say, "Okay, khana itta bura hota tha." I used to say, "Okay, Nahid, what will you bring?" And she said, "I bring chocolate digestive biscuits for you, and I bring smoked salmon for you, and I bring some nice things for you, cheeses and chocolate and stuff." So I used to say, "Okay, okay," and she said, "But remember, Abu will call." So I said, "Okay, I remember, Abu will call." So he said, "Can I talk to my dad, Nahid, please?" अच्छा फिर मैंने उसके साथ बात करने का तरीका सीख लिया. I said, "Waalaikum assalam, Badr Hussain Salim. My name is Jugna Mahsin. I'm from Pakistan. I'm Pakistan Muslim sister of Nahid. How nice to speak to you, daughter. Daughter, tell me where is my daughter? Tell me." And I say, "Abu, Abu Nahid, she is in prefect's meeting." अच्छा Sunday night she is in a prefect's meeting. Saturday night rather. And he'd say, "Wallahi, my daughter is a prefect. Since when, wallahi al-azim?" And I'd say to him, "Ke, oh, you don't know she is prefect? You congratulations, mabruk, she is prefect." So, "Wallahi, daughter, you're giving me sweet message, what do you want from Jeddah, Saudi Arabia?" So I said, "One bottle of Van Cleef & Arpels perfume, please. I send it by FedEx. I send it by FedEx, X, tomorrow." I said, "Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Abu Nahid. Thank you, my daughter. Assalam." I said, "Assalam." Khair, anyway, wo aa jati thi wapas, phir uske baad uske phir shuru ho jata, anar halan. So, you know, Nahid was one character in my life at that time, and there were many other people. But then I went to university, and I developed a real love for the scurrilous satirical magazine Private Eye. And I used to wait for the publication of Private Eye, and every week I would rush to the newsstands to pick up Private Eye. And Private Eye used to have these marvelous covers in which they would just use photographs of the rich and famous of that time, and they'd have these thought balloons or these speech balloons. And I remember, this is 1979, my first year at Cambridge, and I saw this beautiful photograph on the cover of Private Eye, which had the Queen with all her Commonwealth ministers, her Commonwealth Prime Minister standing behind her, posing, and it was a commemorative photograph, right? And there was a speech balloon behind Robert Mugabe, which said, and then there was an array of African and Asian leaders in that picture, and there was the Queen, and there was her Chancellor of the Exchequer, Geoffrey Howe, and there were a few other people sitting in the front row, and all the Prime Ministers at the back, and Robert Mugabe saying to some other black leader, I forget whom now, what's for lunch? And that thought balloon, the speech balloon over the other one was, Sir Geoffrey Howe. So things like that were, you know. And then there was another Private Eye cover in which the Queen was commemorating all her living prime ministers. This was again in 1979, first year of Margaret Thatcher's reign. And there was Margaret Thatcher, and there was James Callaghan, there was Edward Heath, there was Harold Wilson, there was even Harold Macmillan in that photograph. And it was a commemorative, annual Private Eye Anvil, in which they had put together all the old issues, the select sort of things out of the old issues of selection of Private Eye over the last year. And the caption at the top was, all the old jokes together again. So that was, Private Eye was a great inspiration for me. And then I returned to Pakistan, and in my political idealism, I joined the Women's Action Forum. I took part as an activist in a small way in the movement for the restoration of democracy in the mid-80s. And it was a heady time, again, because, you know, Benazir was in exile. And during the movement for the restoration of democracy, we'd be out on the Mall in Lahore. And your fiza goonjti thi is kisam ke naron se, darte hain bandookon wale ek nihatti ladki se. फैले हैं हिम्मत के उजाले एक निहत्ती लड़की से. सो वो एक बंदा नारा लगाता था पीछे से, हम कहते थे एक निहत्ती लड़की से. तो ये सारी चीज़ें गूंजती थी. और वुमेन्स एक्शन फोरम के बिहाफ पे जब हम ज़ियाउल हक साहब के जो कवानीन थे उनके खिलाफ जब प्रोटेस्ट करते थे, ये दियत किसास वगैरह ये सब चीज़ें, औरतों की आदि गवाही वगैरह, तो पहले तो शुरू में तो जब 1983 में ये किस्सा शुरू हुआ तो उस वक्त तो 200 औरत थी लेड बाय हबीब जालिब. वो फिर हमने सब ने सिर फटाए, हमें थाने ले गए, वहाँ हमें धरा रखा इन्होंने वगैरह वगैरह. और मुझे याद है उस वक्त एक दफ़ा हमें सिविल लाइंस थाने उठा के ले गए, उसके बाद कोट लखपत जेल मुंतकिल कर दिया. तो एक मेजर साहब थे, वो बैठे हुए थे पोडियम पर, और जैसे जैसे खवातीन आ रही थी वो सबको पूछे तुम्हारा क्या नाम है. अच्छा, वहाँ पर एक खातून थी, बड़ी भारी भरकम खातून थी, नानी थी, वो मेरी दोस्त की नानी थी, उनको हम सब नानी कहते थे. शी वॉज इन हर 70s एंड शी वॉज अ डिवोटेड भुट्टोआइट. और मदिया गौहर भी थी वहाँ पर, और भी खवातीन, हिना जलानी भी थी, आसमा जहांगीर थी, हम लोग सब थे. तो मेजर साहब पूछ रहे थे, वो अंदराज कर रहे थे, कहते नाम मदिया गौहर, पेशा मतलब आपको पता नहीं है कि मतलब मैं हूँ कौन, मतलब कि क्या मतलब पेशा, मतलब आपको नहीं मतलब पता कि मैं कौन मतलब हूँ. अच्छा, तो इस तरह करके. तो फिर जब नानी की बारी आई तो कहने लगी कि कहते नाम, शी सेड मेरा नाम, मेरा नाम है आशिके जुल्फकार अली भुट्टो, लिख ले. तो वो वेद साहब staring at the ceiling again, and he said, maa ji naa, naa ki tada dasso, main akhe nahi suneya ni tu aashiq e zulfiqar ali putto. Then he gave up and he said, pesha, she said, main, I remember saying this, she said, main high court da judge. So he said ke, maa ji pesha, she said, tu suneya nahi, main thanedar SHO, main hiyan, likh tu hai mera pesha. So he gave up eventually, and then उन्होंने कोट लखपत जेल में. तो इस किस्म के कैरेक्टर्स जो थे, they were all part of one's life. And then as we went along, you know, वो जो वुमेन्स एक्शन फोरम की प्रोटेस्ट की बॉडी थी खवातीन की, वो ड्विंडल करते 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 40 पे आ गई. बट हर इशू के लिए फिर 40 वो खवातीन निकलती थी. तो जब हम नारे लगाते थे कि यू नो के गिरती हुई दीवारों को एक धक्का, और तो इस तरह की चीज़ें हम करते थे. और काले कवानीन नामंजूर, काले कवानीन नामंजूर, औरत की गवाही आधी है, क्यों आधी है, इस तरह करके. तो जो पुलिस वाले थे, दे बिकेम वेरी लैकडेजिकल बाय द एंड ऑफ इट. यूँ खड़े होकर सिगरेटें छीक रहे थे एक दूसरे को. मैं पास से गुजरी तो एक दूसरे के और कौन है याने, ओए चालीस बारह औरतें फिर आ गई ने. वो इस तरह करके ये दिस वॉज द मिलियू इन द 1980s. एंड देन इन 1988 on one day, I won't call it an auspicious day, but on one day, there was a plane crash and General Ziaul Haq died. And that night, Najam and I, my husband Najam Sethi and I, sat up all night talking about the political space that would open up, and we decided that it was time to make an intervention and to publish a paper of our own. Before that, he'd just been in prison. And I remember, you know, this was, we'd been married about 2 years. My son was 3 months old, your friend Ali. And he just one night, he was just picked up. Because he had a bookshop at that time and he was distributing some pro-democracy pamphlets and books, etc. from there, and he'd published some books, pro-democracy books, and critical of Ziaul-Haq and the American role in Pakistan in particular. And they just came and picked him up, etc. It was a very traumatic time for me because, you know, I was 26 years old and I had a baby and I didn't know how to cope with it. And they took him off first to the fort where he was incarcerated with Salman Taseer, the late Shaheed Salman Taseer. And then they transferred him to Kot Lakhpat Jail. So one had to work hard and, you know, it was a traumatic time to get him out. And that was in 1985. So in 1988, and no newspaper dared mention that he had been arrested, that he was incarcerated without cause, and that he had been labeled with treason once again. He's been in prison three times. It's always been treason, nothing less. So we decided in 1988 that it was time to have a newspaper where all sorts of human rights violations could be written about. That was our motivation.
But you had actually applied for permission under your name.
Yes.
And there's a Najam Sethi has written a wonderful article detailing how that happened, the process you went through
to get
it done. And you actually postponed, you asked for a delay, waiting for the auspicious time, and then it happened in 88, right?
That's correct. Yeah. We had applied for the declaration as soon as he came out of prison in 1985. And then we waited until 1988 to actually publish the newspaper.
Right.
And so we published the newspaper. And then we discovered that our advertisers wanted to have color, the ability to print color ads on the front and the back of the paper. And as happens in these things, we had a eureka moment.
Yeah.
I remember Najam woke up in the middle of the night at 3:30 a.m. I remember, switched on the light, and he said, "Sum tum so to nahi rahi?" To maine kaha, "Obviously, main so rahi hun, bhai." So he said, "Bhai, meri baat suno na zara tum." So I put on my side light, and I said, "Kya hai, bhai?" To which he said, "Ke, dekho, the only way we can do this is if I write the editorial on the front page of the paper, and you write some sort of column on the back page of the paper, or somebody else writes some sort of column on the back page, in which case we don't have to print immediate news, in which case we can print 3 days in advance, in which case we can print color advertising." So I said, "Achha bhai, ab to so jao na, to phir kal baat karenge." Anyway, so, and that's how it happened. So he began to write the editorial on the front page, which he still does, and I began to write the diary of Benazir Bhutto to begin with, then the diary of Ishaq Khan, then the diary of a former ambassador to Pakistan, US Ambassador Robert Oakley, and this is how it began. So we could write it in advance, print the ads with it, print it in color, and put the news inside the paper. So I'll just, if you allow me, give you a little excerpt from the time that Robert Oakley, we wrote the Viceroy's Journal when Robert Oakley was the ambassador in Pakistan, the American ambassador in Pakistan.
Please. So his column was called the Viceroy's Journal.
Yeah, it was called the Viceroy's Journal after Lord Wavell's journal, who was the penultimate British Raj Viceroy in India, and he witnessed the beginning of the partition. And then, of course, Lord Mountbatten took over from him. So we had written...
How did you hit upon that name? I'm going to ask you later. You have very good names for all your different columns and characters.
Again, a eureka moment, but I can't find it now in my notes. I'll just be extempore about it. You know, so in one of the pieces that I wrote about in the Viceroy's Journal, I wrote in his voice, I keep talking to them about nuclear non-proliferation. You know, this was the great sort of theme at that. I keep talking to them about nuclear non-proliferation, and they keep talking about their bum. And I'm not sure what that means. I mean, does it mean what I think it means? I'm not sure I know what a lot of things mean here. Like, for instance, I've seen this shop in Apara that says butt sweets. And I've seen these shops in Rawalpindi that one says butt kebab house. And the other one says butt tikka. And yet another one says a butt beauty parlor. And the most perplexing of all is the butt hair salon, you know? I mean, so I'm not sure I know what anything means. So, and you know, in a voice like that, we started doing this. And then I remembered from the time that, of course, Bibi ki jo awaz thi, wo mere zehen mein goonjti thi, and I say this with all the respect and affection and admiration that I can muster for her. Kyunki unke kuch chahne wale hain jo bahut bura mehsoos karte hain jab main unki awaaz mein baat karti hoon. Lekin dekhe wo she didn't want to be a saint, she was not a saint, she was a political leader and she was a woman with a lot of tolerance for the press. Unlike some people these days that we know, she had a lot of tolerance for the press. She was not the midnight knock woman. She would get angry. She said, "You're going to burn in hell for that thing you've written about me. It's not true." So I said, "Yeah, I'll burn in hell, but you know, I mean, you know, sort of, you have no sources, you have no sources, but of course it's your right to defame me." I said, "Nahin, it's not my right." Is kisam ki baatein hoti thi unke saath.
But this is an interesting thing that you've brought up. How do you go about satirizing somebody you actually like and respect?
Well, they give you lots of material to, I mean, for God bless her.
And why?
God bless her for all her faults. Because as press, as independent media, you have to hold up the mirror. Okay, and you have to speak truth to power. In Pakistan now, it's become an occupational hazard to the extent that we fear for our lives.
Yeah.
And you know, everyone here knows that many journalists are in harm's way for trying to speak what they see as the truth. It is their right. You can criticize it, you can take them to court for it, you can pillory them for it, but you can't kill them for it. And we will not be silenced in this manner. We will not be silenced in this manner. One goes down, another one will come up. And we will not be silenced in this manner. This is the urge of the Pakistani middle classes who are now more and more and more vocal through their political parties, through their media, through civil society, through rights organizations, to want a say in the way this country is run, to want more and more economic prosperity in this country. These are ideas whose time has come. You cannot hold back peace with the neighbors. You cannot hold back trade with the neighbors. You cannot hold back more openness, and you cannot hold back accountability for all. You just cannot anymore. And I think we should all wake up and understand this. And Benazir, God bless her, she had a tolerance level, you know, and I must say that Nawaz Sharif now, he went through a time when he wasn't tolerant, but he came back and he, you know, went through this experience of exile, which I think has changed him viscerally in many ways. And he does have tolerance now, and you know, he can disagree with you.
Have you ever had a conversation with him about the Ittefaqnama?
Yes, I have. In the beginning, this is in the 90s, you know, he one day just came over and he was talking to us, and he said, "Ke eh jada, tusi jada behuda ja jada mazmoon ja ja tusi likhde je, chichda ja akhbar hai chota ja." دیکھو نا تسی پڑھے لکھے بندے جے چنگے خاندانی لوگ جے کوئی شوگر مل لا لو کی کرن دی لوڑ ہے اے تانوں بھابی زیب نہیں جے دیندا کم سو ٹو وچ آئی سیڈ میاں صاحب گل ہے کہ اینڈ دین اگین ان اے سبسیکوئنٹ کنورسیشن ہی سیڈ دس اگین اینڈ دس از یو نو ہی سیڈ دس اینڈ دین آف کورس یو نو وی ہیڈ دیٹ ایپیسوڈ وین نجم واز اریسٹڈ ان 1999 and dragged off and all of that, and we had to, you know, fight for his release. And then Nawaz Sharif was toppled, he went abroad into exile to Saudi Arabia. We met him subsequently in 2004, and a lot of the air was cleared at that time, and he understood certain things, and he said ke mainu jamhooriyat da rog lag gaya mainu jamhooriyat da rog lag gaya te mainu pata hai ke jehdi media hai ohnu azad hona pehna hai itthe aur azad hona chahida hai. And he said ke lekin tusi oh column ajje tak likh rahe je, main keh ji miyan sahab main likh rahi haan oh column. And he said oh bas mainu sirf eh si ke elitaan hasdiyan ne pad pad ke. Main keh ji oh te gal hai apni thaan gal e, lekin jehda banda leader hove na oh leader de bare ch likhya janda hai is qisam da column. Aur tuhanu is cheez nu darguzar karna chahiye, tusi vadde bande je, tusi leader je, choti ji cheez hai andar. Then he said chalo theek hai. And I promise you, since then, never once has he said ke tusi ke ki kita hai te sethi sahab ne ki kehta hai, or nothing. He can disagree when we meet him. He sort of says ke mera khayal hai ke is tarah hai, but you know, never the midnight knock, never a threat again. And I think that in that sense he's really learnt. Yes, sorry, carry on.
that's definitely heartening news. But बीबी ने आपको क्यों डांटा, क्या कहा था?
अच्छा, वो ये हुआ कि अब हम तो थ्रू आउट द 80s इस चीज़ पे जो इनके पीपल्स पार्टी के स्लोगन्स थे वी यूज्ड टू टेक देम सीरियसली. अमेरिका का जो यार है खतार है खतार. ठीक है, अब 1986 में वो जब लाहौर वापस आई तो इतना जम गफ़ीर मैंने तो कभी ज़िंदगी में ना देखा था ना देखा है उसके बाद. खैर जब वो हुआ सब कुछ तो मैं सब सड़क पे खड़ी थी उस वक्त, और यानी कि पूरे 12 घंटे लगे एयरपोर्ट से दाता दरबार जाते हुए, और एक मलंग था जो उनके ट्रक के सामने नाच रहा था, और वो उसने वो 12 घंटे नाचता, उसके पैर लहू लुहान हो गए, लेकिन वो ट्रक के सामने जिस तरह के इंसान एक वजद के हाल में होता है. और खैर बीबी भी गुसल खाने नहीं गई और वहाँ खड़ी होकर वो मतलब अपना सारे लीड करती रही प्रोसेशन को. एक औरत हो के मैं उनके गुसल खाने की मुझे ज़्यादा फिक्र थी कि कैसे anyway, तो लेकिन मैंने ये एक नोटिस की बात कि पीछे से जब अमेरिका के झंडे जलने शुरू हुए और जो PSO के बच्चे थे उन्होंने नारे लगाने शुरू किए अमेरिका का, ये कौन नारे लगा रहे हैं, तो वो जहांगीर बदन का तो she said जहांगीर ये नारे नहीं लगेंगे नहीं लगेंगे नहीं लगेंगे. अच्छा तो फिर वो अमेरिका के झंडे नहीं जलेंगे नहीं जलेंगे नहीं जलेंगे. सो देन ही सेड के टू गिव हिम क्रेडिट ही सेड तो जब सारा कुछ अभी भी अगर ये हो गया तो हम इलेक्शन कैसे जीतेंगे फिर. टू विच ही सेड हम कभी नहीं लूजेंगे कभी नहीं लूजेंगे हम हमेशा विनेंगे विनेंगे और विनेंगे.
अच्छा ये बताइए सिंस वी आर ऑन दिस टॉपिक हाउ डज इम द डिम रिस्पॉन्ड टू योर कॉलम.
ओ डियर. अच्छा वो आई हैव टू से अगेन यू नो ट्विटर पे और फेसबुक वगैरह पे बहुत एक्टिव हैं उनके फॉलोअर्स जो इमरानिस्टाज हैं और वो करते रहते हैं तनकीद हमारी बट दैट इज़ देयर राइट एंड यू नो आई कंटिन्यू टू राइट द कॉलम. आई मस्ट से दैट यू नो ही बाय एंड लार्ज इग्नोर्स इट एंड वो कहते हैं कि मैं पढ़ता ही नहीं हूँ. उनको पूछा भी गया ये सवाल लेकिन एक ज़माना था जब ये पढ़ते थे एंड ही यूज़ टू नॉट लाइक इट. और वो ज़माना तब था जब इन दी अर्ली 90s मिड 90s just before Lady Diana, Princess Diana died, she came to Lahore. She came to Lahore ostensibly to raise funds for the Shaukat Khanam Memorial Hospital, basically to check out Dr. Hasnat's family, with whom at that time she was involved in England. And so Imran invited a few people to dinner at his house in Zaman Park to meet Princess Diana. And Najam and I were one of the couple that he invited. So we walked in, he was standing at the sort of entrance, and he said kya hai yaar najam theek thaak, to which najam said ha imran kya hai tumhara. He said to me yaar dekho jugnu main tujhko isi liye bulaya ki yaar ye tum wayat column band kar dena iske baad. To maine kaha acha fir wo dekhi jayegi wagaira wagaira. Lekin then I met Princess Diana there and you know she was not as attractive close up alia as she was, and she was very very photogenic. She was good looking and she was a tall stately woman etc, but she wasn't the bombshell that she appeared to be when
nahi na naak naksha to unka
ha and then she was sort of a straight torso also, she didn't have much anyway. So we got talking and I must say that was a very pleasant conversation, and I knew that in order to get anywhere with her I had to start talking about her kids because a mother can't resist you know talk about her children. So I said your highness you've left Wills and Harry behind in London. So suddenly you know she focused attention. Usse pehle hello nice to meet you yes hello. So wo jab the minute I said your highness you've come all the way here and I appreciate I'm mother of young children you've left Wills and Harry behind in London, suddenly she focused right and she said I know, it's so difficult, so difficult. It's the only difficult part of traveling. I love traveling, but it's so difficult to leave Wills and Harry behind, you know. So I said, yeah, I can understand that completely. My children are young, and I constantly feel guilty about having to leave them whenever I work, etc. She said, you know, and particularly, and I said, and Wills is, and so Harry is so sweet with his mop of red hair. Don't you think? I said, yes, he's a carrot top. I call him my carrot top. He's so sweet. I'm so glad you agree with that. So I said, I know, he's delicious, he really is. He really thinks so. I said, yes. So I said, how has it been? And by this time, we were having this nice conversation. So I said, well, how's it been since you've been here? Oh, you know what happened? You know those fairy lights? I'm staying here in Imran's house. New, I'm living up there in that bedroom. But you see those fairy lights there? Oh, but choti choti wo light. You know what happened? I drew myself a bath. But before I immersed the whole of myself in it, I just tested it with my thumb, or with my toe, the water, just to test the water. And you know, I got a little electric shock. And you know, I'm so glad I did that before immersing the whole of myself in it. Can you imagine? Can you imagine the headline, the Daily Mail, Princess Diana electrocuted in Imran Khan's bathroom? I mean, you know. So I said, yes, I mean, that's something that I'm so glad you avoided. But then she was very gracious, and then she went off after that, and nothing came of the Hasnath affair because, you know, she died tragically in that accident. So everyday life, everyday occurrences, everyday meetings with people, everyday inspirations give you the wherewithal for the column on the back page.
Achha, last but not least, what about the Qaid-e Qiwam? How does he respond to you?
Bas kya bataun aapko, wo inki ek bahut jise kehte hain mercurial and up and down volatility. Mere saath to koi taluk nahi hai unka, apart from one or two things that sometimes he's taken objection to. Wo bhi kyunki basically ek angrezi ka akhbar, weekly akhbar, usko wo itna seriously nahi lete jitna wo najm ke tabsiron ko jo tv pe aate hain unka wo bura manate hain. तो ये होता है कि कभी कभार जब खुश थे तो उस वक्त आई बिकेम भाभी एंड नजम बिकेम नजम भाई, और वो फ़ोन किया करते थे और बात किया करते थे उनसे. और जब वो नाराज़ हुए उनसे बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन थिंग्स दैट ही सेड, सो ही रैंग अप एंड ही रैंग ऑन माय मोबाइल नंबर व्हिच हिज ऑपरेटर इन लंदन हैज़. And he just put me through straight away, and I didn't have an opportunity to say ki ji main abhi meeting mein hu to main thodi der ke baad baat kar lungi wagaira. I couldn't do that, so wo phone pe aa gaye,
"Babi,
ab I have to drink some water before I do that."
"Babi, kya kar diya aapke shohar ne?"
So I decided कि मैं तो इनके साथ आर्ग्यू नहीं करूँगी, और कोई मैंने उनका जवाब नहीं देना, कोई मैंने उनकी कोई हिमायत नहीं करनी अपने शोहर की इस मामले में. There's no point. तो मैंने तो बस हथियार फेंक दिया. मैंने कहा कि अल्ताफ भाई क्या बताऊँ आपको, मैं खुद भी बहुत तंग हूँ. So he immediately latched on to that.
भाभी हुक्म कीजिए. आप अपने भाई को हुक्म कीजिए.
सोहसर अल्ताफ भाई, आप लंदन में, आपकी तंजीम कराची में.
बहन, भाभी, ये बात न भूलिएगा कि पाकिस्तान में लाकानूनियत सारे मुल्क में है. अल्लाह की मेहरबानी से आपके भाई के बड़े लंबे हाथ हैं.
And so on. और रोज़मर्रा की ज़िंदगी में भी बड़ी चीज़ें होती हैं जो कि आई कॉन्ट हेल्प नोटिसिंग, यू नो.
आज क्या हुआ, कुछ हुआ?
खैर, मैं जब आने लगी तो मैंने पहले कल आना था यहाँ पर, तो आ जाने से पहले आई जस्ट वेंट टू द ऑफिस टू क्लियर अप अ फ्यू थिंग्स वगैरह. तो जो मेरी ऑपरेटर है, शी इज़ अ यंग वूमन, उसका नाम है फरा. तो आई फर्स्ट ट्राई टू गेट थ्रू टू अ कॉलीग ऑफ माइन ऑन द फोन फ्रॉम होम. And the phone was constantly engaged. The exchange was engaged. All the numbers. खैर, मैंने कहा मैं जाके दफ्तर पता करूँ कि हुआ क्या. मैडम फराज ऑन द फोन विद सम सूटर और द अदर. तो मैंने उसको कहा, मैंने बुलाया, मैंने कहा फरा देखो ना, ये सारा वक्त एक्सचेंज जो ब्लॉक रहता है और कई कई मिनट फ़ोन करते रहते हैं, तुम फ़ोन नहीं उठाती, ये वो. बिजी थी ना लाइन? मैंने कहा हाँ, मुझे पता है बिजी थी लाइन. तो फरा तुम शादी क्यों नहीं कर लेती, शादी कर लो तुम, मेडिव मैरिज में क्या पड़े.
अच्छा.
मैंने कहा क्यों फरा, मैरिज में तो बड़ी अल्लाह की मेहरबानी से दुनिया में जन्नत हो सकती और दुनिया में जहन्नम भी हो सकती. मैंने कहा कि हाँ ये भी है, ये भी है, लेकिन देखो ना, मैं कहना तो ये चाहती थी कि भाई लाइन अनब्लॉक कर दो, जाके इस बेचारे से शादी कर लो ताकि हम अपना काम कर सकें वगैरह वट एवर.
मैडम आपको मैं बताऊँ, मेरी एक कज़न सिस्टर है, उनका नाम है अरूज. अब देखे ना 5 ईयर्स हुए उनके मैरिज को, तो 5 ईयर्स में ना 4 किड्स हो गए उनके. तो मैं गई ना हॉस्पिटल उस दिन उनको देखने, जब उनका 4th किड हुआ तो मैंने जाके कहा, मैं कहा अरूज सिस्टर अब ये कॉमा है कि फुल स्टॉप है. तो अरूज ने मुझे कहा, फरा अगर ये भी कॉमा है तो फिर मैं भी खुद कॉमे में ना चली जाऊँ.
So, did you hire her for her wit and wisdom?
Everybody has wit and wisdom. The point is to see it. So, you know, somebody else might think this is a perfectly sort of boring thing to say, but I don't. I think it's hilarious.
I think it's very wise.
And very insightful and worth remembering.
Acha, now, a couple of more serious questions I wanted to ask you. Now, how do you actually manage to produce your column so regularly? When you sit down to write it, does it always flow? Are there moments when it's hard and you really have to rack your brains?
Yes, it's difficult sometimes. It's not filbadi and it's not inspirational all the time. Any job is difficult and boring at times, and it's sometimes, you know, you rack your brains and you obviously one has to, you know, sort of look at other sources as well. Sometimes you have to use jokes, sometimes you have to use inspiration. My friend Seema Iftikhar, who knows Imran very well because he's been her ex-husband Yusuf Salahuddin's best friend for a very long time, she helps me write the Im the Dim column, and she has an amazing, fantastic, scurrilous sense of humor. Really, really scurrilous sense of humor, and she has the capacity to laugh at herself. In fact, she and I launching a collected version of How's That by Im the Dim soon, and it says by Jugnu Mohsin with Seema Iftikhar. So I want to acknowledge her in that book for her help, and that book is dedicated to all of Pakistan's liberal fascists, beghairats and dollar khors. So that's
do you work in collaboration with others on any of your other columns?
No, I don't. My sister writes the diary of the Social Butterfly on the back page of the Friday Times. I write the Ittefaqnama off the top of my head. I write Im the Dim with Seema, and the other columns that came and went, etc. But as I told you, you know, there is so much input from it in it, from daily life, from meeting people. And I'm also a farmer, and I have a sort of I run my parents' trust in my ancestral village. We have 4,000 children in school. We have a health unit. We have, you know, basic langar khanas and various things which I try and do. I go there every weekend, and I have to juggle this with all my other work, etc. But I find so much inspiration there. अब जब ये कनक तो अभी हार्वेस्ट होनी शुरू हो गई है और इसका रेट भी अब गवर्नमेंट में आ गया है वगैरह, लेकिन इससे पहले बारिशें बड़ी होती रही हैं, पंजाब में भी हुई हैं बड़ी बारिशें. और जो जब कनक राइपन कर रही होती है तो द लास्ट थिंग यू नीड इज़ बारिश. तो जो मेरा मुंशी है उसको मैं जब जाती हूँ वहाँ, तो मैं सबको कहती हूँ कि देखो अपनी मादरी ज़बान में बात करनी चाहिए. और वहाँ पर लोग एक बड़ी ठेठ पंजाबी बोलते हैं, बड़ी बेहतरीन पंजाबी बोलते हैं, जो मैं भी बोलती हूँ क्योंकि वो मेरी मादरी ज़बान है. लेकिन एक साहब हैं जो इंसिस्ट करते हैं कि जी मैंने उर्दू बोलनी. अब मैं उनको मैंने कहा कि अशरफ दसो मैनू कि कणक का की हाल है. आई स्पोक इन माई नेटिव पंजाबी. सो ही सेड क्या हाल होना, मैंने बताया तो है आपको कि जो हालात है ये तो बारिश तो मुक्ति नहीं है, तो क्या होना है फिर कणक का. मैं कह मैं अशरफ मैनू ऐ दसो तुसी कि रेट की मिलेगा कणक का सानू ऐतकी, जिते जे लम्मी पैगी तो मुड़ की होगा, या कट्टी गई तो फिर बारिश पैगी तो फिर की होगा, तुसी दसो ना. क्यों ये तो जो खुले आसमान के नीचे तजारत है, ये खुले आसमान के नीचे तजारत है, तो ये एक जुआ किस्म की गेम है जो हम करते हैं, जो हम लोग काश्तकार हैं. अब मैंने कहा अब सोचते हैं गेम ऐसा ऐसा मियां अशरफ मेरी गल सुनो, तुसी अपनी मादरी जबान क्यों नहीं तुसी बोल ला, जे मैं पंजाबी बोलना शुरू कर कोई मनेगा कि मैं BA पास हाँ. And so on and so forth. So now you can, you know, use this inspiration sometimes to transfer. For instance, when I write the Ittefaqnama, I think in Punjabi and write in English. सो आप समझ सकती हैं फिर उसमें.
Can you give us a little example?
What goes of my father? Put earth. मिट्टी पाओ जी मिट्टी पाओ. Various things. There is very black and lentil. These days there is black and lentil. And I have been eating pushes. I am politician. I have to eat pushes. And your bhabhi has done finishes. Khatam karwaye hain.
Have you ever thought about writing a whole book, not collecting your columns and publishing them, but actually exploring a lot of this in greater detail, because a column only allows you so much scope?
I think other people can write far better books than I can. I, you know, sort of struggle to manage my social work in the village, my farming, my weekly column, the overseeing the marketing of my newspaper. I have aging parents. My sister lives abroad. I have two young adult children. I have a husband who's always causing trouble.
So bhai ko hukum diya kabhi?
Bhai ko maine hukum diya hai, lekin wo shahzade hain aur wo apni marzi karte hain aur supportive hain wo aur apna wo karte hain, help karte hain, lekin apni zindagi apni hai, unki apni hai. Aur sirf main apni meri jo एक जो मैं किसी सूरत कॉम्प्रोमाइज़ नहीं करना चाहती, वीकनेस वो ये है कि 9 से 10 बजे तक मुझे जियो कहानी पे मेरा सुल्तान ज़रूर देखना है. अब दैट इज़ अनदर फैसिनेटिंग सब्जेक्ट.
यस इंडीड,
एब्सोल्युटली फैसिनेटिंग सब्जेक्ट. एंड यू नो दैट हैड दिस बीन यू नो द इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट, लेट्स से 600 years ago, 700 years ago, we would have understood everything that they were saying, because Turki was the native tongue of the Mughals, right? And Gulbadan Banu Begum, who was Babur ki, jo to uske Babri mein unka itna zikr hai wagaira, Babur Badshah khud, wo ye zuban jante the, wo ye zuban bola karte the.
Yes, well, unlike the writers of Mera Sultan, Babur was actually very funny and uses irony and satire in the Babarnama all the time.
That's
he
right.
knew how to laugh at himself.
Yes.
At the exigencies of his life as a Timurid prince, he had to do everything he had to do as a leader, but he saw the ridiculous in it.
And you know, when he spoke about, for instance, one of his campaigns, and he in Tutuz ke Babri, wo keh Babarname mein kehte hain wo ke at the end of the campaign he noticed that he had no feeling left in his feet, and that is because the soles of his feet had become so thick with wear and tear. And you know, you that image I can't forget, because you know, you understand that there was a lot of hardship and a lot of poverty in the foundations of this huge empire. So ye baatein nahi bhulti. Aur phir jo baat mujhe jo doctor saab baithe hain samne, and he lives in KP province on the banks of the Indus, aur Babur ne likha hai ki when he crossed the Indus he saw rhinoceros roaming freely on that land. And you know, to think of what we've become and the wildlife that we've lost and all of that. So yes, whenever I have a moment, I also like to read.
Actually, where I was going with that was to ask, you have had the opportunity to actually meet with and converse with all the people you write about, which is not necessarily every journalist's good fortune. And betakallufi ke saath milke aap logon se mil sakti hain. Of all our political leaders, can you think of anyone who struck you as being able to laugh at themselves? It's a rare quality.
That's an interesting question. You know, you may find this surprising, but you know, Bibi didn't have the capacity to laugh at herself. She was tolerant because she was democratic by temperament, but and by training. Okay, but she didn't have the capacity to laugh at herself. Imran certainly doesn't have the capacity to. Kya yaar ye bakwas? Kya ye bagharat? Sare bagharat? Ye menopausal aurte likhti hain. Ye acha, so wo to he doesn't have the capacity to laugh at himself. I've surprisingly found that Mia Nawaz Sharif has the capacity to laugh at himself. And if you're dasso tusi fir saadi wo saadi handi pakti pai aaj kal and ji and then he has I think that you know somewhere and surprisingly I found General Musharraf very tolerant.
I was going to ask.
He was very tolerant. For instance, I wrote once on the back page of the Friday Times in my Sach Gup column that something that had happened between him and one of the generals who were heading the CENTCOM at that time. I don't know who it was, the general, I forget who it was, but he actually picked up the phone and he called, right? And Farah's predecessor, who was a young man, was
wise and witty.
he was flabbergasted and I was sitting in the office and he said, Bibi, main lagda General Musharraf da phone hai. Toh main kya ke, acha. So he was on the line and he said, ke, so who informed you about this discussion that I had with the General of Central Command? So I said, General Sahib, a good journalist cannot reveal her sources. So I said, General, I can't reveal my sources. And it was, I couldn't say anything else. And there was sort of silence for a split second. All right, take care. Yes, 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 yes. But he didn't pursue the matter. And then talked about, how is Najib? How are you? And he put the phone down. But he didn't pursue the matter at all. Although he was concerned enough about it to actually pick up the phone and ask how that leaked. And yet when I said I can't reveal my sources, he didn't harangue me or harass me or anything like that.
Ever get any feedback from General Musharraf on Mush and Bush?
Yes. Once, again, and this is there was mention of some person who was very close to him who had done a deal with some timber mafia man. And again, this was part of the column. And this time, he sent somebody to the house to ask who this person was, you know, who was in this sanctum sanctorum of his, who had done the deal with the timber mafia man. And he sent this man. And when I was summoned to the drawing room where he was sitting with Najam, Najam was sitting there, sort of collapsed in his chair, like staring at the ceiling. And you know, the expression on his face was, I cause enough trouble for myself. Why do you have to cause this trouble for me, for us? And this, the guy was sitting, the brigadier or whoever he was sitting next to him. And he had this smile and Bhabi Islam Nik. When he got up, you know, they're very sort of polite in that way. And he said, ki ji, wo ye, aap zara mujhe thoda bata dein ki ye kaun sahab hai, you know, it causes this, that. So I said, मैंने आपको पहले भी कहा है और मैं अब भी कह रही हूँ कि I will not reveal my sources and I will not tell you who this is. So Najam looked at him and said, हुन तुहानू लग पता गया कि मैं किस तरह रहना. to which the gent said, you know, he sort of had so much sympathy for him, you know, and he just then again once more tried and said, ki agar aap meherbani kare to main ke nahi ji aap chai pijiye, would you like some samosas, ye wo, ye baat aage na karein, ye nahi baat hogi. Then right there in front of me he rang up, he picked up the phone, he rang somebody in General Musharraf's office and he said, ji, and he said, I'm sorry but I'm going to do this in front of you. And he said, ji wo begum sahib bahut teeth hain aur oh nahi gal nahi sunde, I'm so sorry, main kamyab nahi hoya is gal. And then they forgot about it. But you know, he just wanted to know who it was, and you can't do that because then you, nobody will ever tell you anything after that. Doctor sahab, bring back the rhinoceroses. Aapne pucha doctor sahab, aap rhinoceroses le aaye Indus ke banks pe phir to phir puchiyega ye sawal mujhse.
Should we open it up to the audience since Dr. Saab has taken the first step?
No, I was just had to be kind. You said that those were times in the 70s when many things were happening. Landed class, like you were worried about, the land reforms, and the others, you know, there were radical movement that started. Najm was amongst the radicals.
Absolutely.
How did you choose a radical at this time? Tell me. you are from the landed class.
You know, the thing is that, as I told you, I have to say here that one of my aunts, her name was the late Kishwar Abid Hussain, who is my cousin Abida Hussain's mother. She, when my parents were away on the farm, I used to spend a lot of time with my khala in Lahore. My khala was a very political person. She was an idealist. She was one of, you know, the world's last innocents also. She was very close to the NAP, National Awami Party leadership, and she was, in her own way, a radical lady of her time. And she was a great inspiration, and I got, you know, a lot of, I got my inspiration from her, and she would, she was very encouraging of me. So, Dr. Saab, I grew up in a different milieu from the rest of the family in that sense, because she was a radical in the family, if you know what I mean. And so I had heard about Najm, and when I went to university, I went to a supervision at Clare College, which was his alma mater at Cambridge. And we are a decade apart. He's a decade older than me. And this is in 1979. And he had just come out of prison on the Hyderabad conspiracy case trial, where he was with Khair Bakhsh Madi and Ataullah Mengal and Wali Khan, wagaira. And he had started his little bookshop in Lahore at that time. And my supervisor was a man called Dr. Colin Turpin, who had happened to be Najm's tutor 10 years earlier at Clare. And there were six of us, or five of us, in the supervision. And you just basically, in the first supervision, you get to know each other. And he asked one by one, you know, where do you come from, and where do you come from, and what do you do, etc. And two of them, three of them were old Etonians, you know, who had just come to Cambridge naturally. I was the only foreigner there. So I told him that I was from Lahore. And for the rest of the supervision, he just spoke about Najm. He said that, you know, when he was in prison, he tried to contact Amnesty International. Amnesty International had made him a prisoner of conscience. They had been very concerned about him. They'd offered him, you know, to come back to Clare and teach, and, you know, because he was an economist there, etc. And he hadn't taken up that offer, and they were concerned about him. And he said, I want you to, when you go back to Lahore, try and put me in touch with him, because I've lost touch with him. So I said, I don't know him, but I'll try and find out where he is. And then somebody else, Dr. Rajit Singh, who was an economist at Queen's College, Cambridge, if you remember, Dr. Saab, he had taught Najm also, and I happened to come across him somewhere. And he also spoke about him. So I was sort of, you know, and I, in Baji's house, Baji Kishwar, my late khala, in her house there was a lot of hushed talk of these young men who'd gone off from Lahore's middle class families for solidarity with the Baloch, etc. And so, you know, my curiosity was piqued. I was very curious about him. And then my very, very dear friends, Ali and Noman Majid, who I got to know in London when I was a student at the bar and they were at Sussex, and Noman was at London as well. We became very close friends, and they were friends of Najm's as well, and they introduced me to him, finally introduced me. Usse pehle, a year before that, I arrived in Lahore and I found Vanguard Books, right? And I went to the store. It was a small store, and I saw this tall man standing there, and he looked like the owner. So I walked up to him and I said, "Aap Sethi Saab hai?" To which he said, "Ji." So I said, "We have many friends in common, and Dr. Colin Turpin was asking about you." He didn't give me the time of day. So I thought to myself, you know, this guy, there's something wrong with him, because, you know, I'm hot shakes, and I'm, you know.
Are you sure that isn't what attracted you?
Well, and I said no, and I thought, you know, because at Cambridge the ratio was 6 men to 1 woman, and, you know, if you were young and attractive and all the rest of it, you were used to some kind of attention, right? And he wasn't giving me the time of day. And I said to myself, that pagal hai, you know. So I dismissed him.
You didn't take it as a challenge?
I didn't take it as a challenge, my dear Alia. No, I didn't. And then subsequently, when, of course, I met him with Ali and Nomi, and we got to know each other. And and then I, you know, told my parents that I would like to marry him. And they said, ki hum to Sayyid hain, aur wo to Sheikh hain, aur to ye ho hi nahi sakta. Thereby hangs a tale. But I just have to say this, for the young women who may be here in this audience listening. We had a miserable wedding. But touch wood, it's been a very grand and happy marriage, touch wood. In Pakistan, it's mostly the other way around. It's a very grand and happy wedding, and it's a miserable marriage. So I would urge you young people here
to have miserable weddings.
Miserable weddings.
Bilkul.
And grand and happy relationships, which are sort of equal relationships, if you can.
जुगनू हम पूछना चाहेंगे कि जो हमें बहुत मजा आता है पढ़ के वो है डायरी ऑफ द सोशल बटरफ्लाई और हमारे मियां सरवर नकवी मुझे पढ़ के सुनाते हैं नाश्ते की मेज पे और मुझसे नाश्ता होता नहीं और मैं आई एम इन रोलिंग विथ लाफ्टर तो अब ये बताइए ये आप और आपकी बहन दोनों मिलके करते हैं कि ज्यादातर ये उन्हीं का है
ये सिर्फ मोनी का काम है
अच्छा
और वो मुझे लंदन से ईमेल करती है और कहती है कि फिल मी इन विद ऑल द गॉस So I fill her in with all the goss, and she writes the butterfly.
And you do the research?
No, no, I don't. I just sort of tell her what's happening.
There's can we have the mic here?
Afzal Khan saab, mere purane colleague hain, aur inki badi izzat karti hoon main. Inhone hume journalism sikhaya hai.
No, meri beti pooch rahi thi ki ye jugnu hain. Maine kaha usse pehle shuru hone se pehle. मैंने कहा इनसे अच्छा बहुत कम मिमिक करती हैं तो मेरा एक सवाल वो तो आप सब ने देख लिया मेरा एक सवाल है कि भुट्टो साहब के साथ भी हम रहे तो भुट्टो साहब भी बड़ा अच्छा मिमिक करते थे कभी उनको भी आपने मिमिक किया है
नहीं
आप तो यंग थी
खान साहब उस वक्त मैं मुझे याद नहीं मुझे मैं मतलब देखती थी उनके जलसे जुलूस वगैरह वो खानदान वाले हमारे कांप रहे होते थे एंड ऑब्वियसली दे हेटेड हिम For different reasons, और मेरी खाला और मैं हम चुप करके आपस में कह रहे थे कि she used to say to me, अल्लाह दी शान है देख ले अल्लाह दी शान है कि नहीं And I used to say, बाजी बिल्कुल अल्लाह दी शान है वेखो तो सही तुसी And she said, नौकर वैसे बड़े बदतमीज हो गए ने And I say, हाँ हैं लेकिन उन्हों का हक नहीं बिल्कुल हक है उन्हों का बिल्कुल सही है अल्लाह दी शान है
एक छोटा सा वाक्य मैं सुनाता हूँ नजम उस वक्त ज्वाइन कर रहे थे जियो
हाँ
जियो ज्वाइन कर रहे थे तो जुगनू और नजम आए हुए थे यहाँ इस्लामाबाद और एक दोस्त के घर खाना था हमने वहाँ बैठ के तो इंडिया पाकिस्तान का वो सेमीफाइनल भी देखा तो वहाँ ये बहस छिड़ी थी कि नजम को कितने पैसे मिल रहे हैं जियो से कोई कुछ कह रहा था कोई कुछ कह रहा था तो बहरहाल आखिर में जुगनू ने कहा कि भाई इतने लाख और इतने हज़ार बड़े मतलब एग्जैक्ट फिगर बताई इन्होंने तो मैंने कहा वो भाभी वो 5 करोड़ बोनस कहते हैं मिला है उनको एडवांस वो उसका क्या कहने की अच्छा वो भी मिला है मैंने कहा वो पाउंड में मिलता है और नजम इसलिए लंदन में जाते हैं कोई और वहाँ रखी हुई है
अच्छा वैसे अफजल खान साहब मैं तो दसा होया इसी तरह ही पाउंड बोनस शोनस तो नहीं मिले लेकिन एक बारी सानू जिसले चौधरी परवेज अलाई साहब वजीरे आला सन पंजाब तो उन्हें अपने दफ्तर सद्या कि तुसी मेरे नाल आके कप चाह दा पियो तो कोई गुफ्तगू करिए असी उत्थे गए उन्होंने दफ्तर तो असी अगे अगे टुर रहे सां उन्हें ना लिखाए सन उत्थे जुगनू मोहसिन नजम सेठी असी अगे अगे टुर रहे सां पिछे उन्होंने कुछ अहलकार टुर रहे सन सॉरी आई हैव टू लैप्स इन टू पंजाबी टू से दिस अच्छा एनीवे तो आई हर्ड वन ऑफ देम सेइंग टू द अदर ए कौन है नहीं क्या ए ओ एने जी शहर च रखी हुई है तो दूसरी जी मिसेस सेठी वह पिंड च
मैं पूछना चाह रही थी कि आपने अभी मेंशन किया कि आपको मेरा सुल्तान बहुत पसंद है और आप बहुत देखती हैं तो आप खुर्रम सुल्तान से क्या इंस्पिरेशन लेती हैं क्योंकि यहाँ लेडीज बहुत ज़्यादा इंस्पायर्ड हैं और बहुत इम्प्रेस्ड हैं खुर्रम सुल्तान के टैक्टिक्स और उसके सारे दरबारी जो
अच्छा खुर्रम सुल्तान अच्छा होना नहीं चाहिए होना मैं इसलिए देखती हूँ उस पर मुझे बड़ी खामियां नज़र भी आती हैं बहुत खामियाँ हैं इट्स टू ग्लैमराइज्ड इट्स a lot of it is fiction obviously it's fictionalized wagaira लेकिन यू नो आई हैव अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ सिक फैसिनेशन विद इट, और वो मुझे इसलिए फैसिनेट करता है क्योंकि मैंने कुछ थोड़ी बहुत सुल्तान सुलेमान की तारीख पढ़ी है, थोड़ी पढ़ी है, कुछ चंद किताबें पढ़ी हैं, और क्योंकि मुझे तारीख पढ़ने का शौक़ है, लेकिन सुल्तान सुलेमान की जो असल ज़िंदगी थी ना, वो उससे वो मुझे उससे एक सिख फैसिनेशन इसलिए है क्योंकि अब आगे चलेंगे तो वो अपना सबसे बेहतरीन बेटा जो है, और वो है शहज़ादा मुस्तफ़ा, उसको अपने हाथ से सुल्तान सुलेमान कत्ल करते हैं, और अपने सामने एक पर्दे के पीछे खड़े होके, और सामने शहज़ादा मुस्तफ़ा जो है, अच्छा उनके डेफ एंड डम म्यूट्स जो थे, जो तब कभी पैलेस में या उनके साथ होते थे, वो लोग जो सुन नहीं सकते थे और उनकी जिनकी ज़बानें कटी जाती थी, वो उनके गुलामानों में से उनके सबसे चहेते गुलाम हुआ करते थे, उनसे वो शहज़ादे मुस्तफ़ा को मरवाता बुलाता है, शहज़ादे को पता है कि मुझे मेरे बाप ने कत्ल करना है, और वो आता है अपने बाप से मिलने, और वो अपने बेटे को कत्ल कर देता है। अच्छा, अब ये मुस्तफ़ा जो है, ये सबसे टैलेंटेड शहज़ादे, जो उसके जो औलाद थी शहज़ादगान में से सबसे टैलेंटेड, सबसे अच्छा उसका बेटा था, और हुरम सुल्तान और रुस्तम पाशा जो उसका वज़ीर था, ये हकीकत है और ये तारीख का हिस्सा है कि वो सुल्तान के ऊपर इतने गालिब आ गए और उसको इतना उसके कान भरे कि उन्होंने शहज़ादे के ख़िलाफ़ उसको बिल्कुल कर दिया, और उसने अपने बेटे की जान अपने हाथ से ली, और फिर 5 दिन उसकी लाश अपने हाथ में लेके उसके ऊपर रोता रहा। अब मुझे ये चीज़ें मालूम हैं, तो मैं इस चीज़ को देखती हूँ कि ये कैसे इसको ट्रीट करते हैं, और इससे सबक बहुत हासिल होते हैं, क्योंकि जो हुरम सुल्तान की जो सारी काविशें थीं, कोशिशें थीं, वो राख में बन गई, राख हो गई, जबकि उसका एक और बेटा था बेज़त, उसको भी इसी तरह वो भी बागी हो गया, उसको भी सुल्तान ने कत्ल करवाया वगैरह। लोग हैं ख़ास तौर पे ख़वातीन जो ये प्रोग्राम बड़े शौक़ से देख रही हैं, और मैं इस चीज़ की जवाब चाहती हूँ कि क्यों, क्योंकि आफ्टर ऑल हमारी साइकी कुछ चीज़ की समझ आएगी ये सोच के समझ के कि हमें ये प्रोग्राम इतना पसंद क्यों है। आप में से कोई अगर इसके बारे में मुझे बताना चाहे तो ज़रूर बताए।
ज़्यादातर ख्वातीन इसी वजह से देख रही हैं।
मुझे तो इसकी ज़बान बहुत पसंद है, खिंचती चली गई।
हाँ बिल्कुल, उसमें उर्दू डबिंग बहुत अच्छी है, उर्दू बेहतरीन है जी, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल। लेकिन ना हुरम सुल्तान की जो ये सारी मैशिनेशंस थीं, जो इनकी सारी वो तदबीरें थीं, वो सब खाक हो गई, और वो 55 साल या 56 साल की उम्र में वो मर गई, और सुल्तान सुलेमान उनके लिए रोते रह गए पीछे से, और फिर सारी औलाद बर्बाद हो गई, और उस्मानिया सल्तनत की भी बर्बादी वहाँ से शुरू होगी। तो इन चीज़ों का भी हमें सबक। जी हाँ जी जी,
वी आर आउट ऑफ टाइम out of time, but we're going to take one more question
over there.
Yeah,
I think
Dr. Framji Minwala right there, because he had his hand raised. It's the last one.
Actually, I'm going to ask a different question than I asked before. Do you think that the satire that you do of our political leaders has had any political effect or social effect? And secondly, could you tell the story again that you told in Lahore that I actually missed hearing?
Which story? Okay.
The story, quickly, very quickly, Framji, about the effect. I think in this case, the openness that you see in society today, the quest for more and more freedom, this vibrant media that we have, some people call it Madar Pidar Azad media, other people call it Azad media. ये इस तरह होता है, जब चीज़ें नई नई शुरू होती हैं तो वो एक pendulum swing करता है, एक्सट्रीम पे जाता है, फिर वापस आता है, फिर इत्तेदाल हासिल करते हैं institutions, लोग वगैरह। So we are in the throes of this. We are in the journey of democracy. We're in the midst of it, and it's causing mayhem. And many journalists are collateral damage in this, and we are all caught in the crossfire. But we have no choice but to continue with on this journey, and that is what we're doing. And it's all qatra qatra daryas. You know, one satirical column here, one brave journalist on the electronic media. Once, it's all part of the same bouquet and the same journey of democracy. As far as your father, Happy Minwala's story is concerned, this, again, I say, and I say this, I repeat this with a lot of affection for the late Shaheed Benazir Bhutto. I remember this when she was trying to assail Islamabad in the early 90s, and she was trying to lead a long march. And she was trying to get an appointment to the then American ambassador, who was not giving her the time of day, right? and Najam and I came to see her in Islamabad, and she was sitting there in Islamabad in her rest house, whichever house she had, you know, on these Roche Bobois sofas, and all her leadership was standing behind her, and she was sitting alone on the sofa. The sofa was empty, the rest of the sofa was empty. So we walked, come and sit here, Najam, come and sit here, Jugno. Just have some fruit, have some chocolate. The German ambassador just sent me these lovely chocolates. So anyway, so well, by the way, what Roche, sorry, kya kehte hain, Ferrero Rocher, jo
Ferrero Rocher, haan.
So wo, some friend of mine had a Bottega, I'm digressing, a Bottega Veneta bag, which is a very expensive bag. So kisi ne kaha ke, why don't you have one of these bags? I said, I can't afford it, it's too expensive, ye wagara. So one day, Najam was in his, you know, so mood mein the, to kehne lage ke, main tenu gift la deya ek. ਕਿਹੜੀ ਗਿਫਟ? ਉਹ ਫਰੈਰੋ ਰੋਸ਼ਰ ਦਾ ਬੈਗ. ਫਰੈਰੋ ਰੋਸ਼ਰ ਦਾ ਬੈਗ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ, ਬੋਟੇਗਾ ਵੈਨੇਟਾ ਦਾ ਬੈਗ ਹੈਗਾ. ਐਨੀਵੇ, ਆਈ ਡਿਡਨਟ ਗੈਟ ਇਟ. ਖੈਰ, ਆਈ ਡਾਈਗ੍ਰੈਸ. ਬਟ ਐਨੀਵੇ, ਸੋ ਵਹਾਂ ਬੈਠ ਕੇ ਮੈਂ ਕਹਿਣੇ ਲੱਗੀ ਕਿ ਲੁੱਕ ਐਟ ਦਿਸ, ਦੀ ਅਮੈਰੀਕਨ ਅੰਬੈਸਡਰ ਵੋਂਟ ਗਿਵ ਮੀ ਦ ਟਾਈਮ ਆਫ ਡੇ. ਕੈਨ ਯੂ ਇਮੈਜਿਨ, ਇਟਸ ਆਲ ਹੈਪੀ ਮਿਨਵਾਲਾਸ ਫਾਲਟ. So I said, why is it Happy Minwala's fault, Bibi? Don't you remember Happy Minwala used to be my ambassador when I first became Prime Minister, first elected Prime Minister of Muslim country? I said, yeah, first elected woman Prime Minister of Muslim country, daughter of Shaheed Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, granddaughter of Sir Shahnawaz Bhutto, Prime Minister Junagadh State. I said, so why is it Happy's fault? No, I went to Washington for my first state visit to DC, and then in the evening I came back to my hotel. What was it, Janu? Was it Four Seasons? Or yes, I think it was the Four Seasons in DC. I was sitting there in the evening, and Happy came and said to me, Bibi, Governor Arkansas and his wife are in the lobby. They've been waiting for you for 2 days. They just want a photo op with you. 5 minutes, just want an autograph. They want to come and see you. I said, Happy, I'm first woman, elected woman, Prime Minister of Muslim country, daughter of Shaheed Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, first democratically elected Prime Minister of Pakistan, granddaughter of Sir Shahnawaz Bhutto, Prime Minister of Junagadh State, who's Governor Arkansas? to which Happy apparently sort of tried to, you know, present the case against it. But Bibi, you know, they're great fans of yours, you know, they supported you while you were in exile in prison, etc., and you know, they're Democrats and they're a young you know, political couple. But Happy, I'm first elected woman Prime Minister of Muslim country, daughter of Shaheed Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, first elected Democratic Prime Minister of Republic of Pakistan, first Sir Shahnawaz Bhutto's granddaughter, Prime Minister, who's Governor Arkansas? Happy, they just want a photo op. No, but Happy, but who's Governor Arkansas? Anyway, I came back to Pakistan, you know, and now, and how was I to know that Governor Arkansas is going to become President of the United States of America and she's going to be Hillary Clinton? It's all Happy's fault. Happy should have told me. Maybe this is what happened. And today the American ambassador, he's President of the United States, and the American ambassador won't give me time of day.
On that note. Thank you so much.
She is. I'm a stand-up comedian. I'm in the line of fire. I'm collateral damage. I'm everything.
You're on the stage.
Television.